Hi guys, welcome to the Great Outdoors RV. My name is Mate.
And my name is Isaiah. We are at the Great Outdoors RV Company off of Highway 85 in Evans, Colorado.
We are looking at the Wildwood 273QBXL. Some cool factors for the Wildwood 273QBXL. One, bunk beds. Two, half-ton towable. And three,
outside kitchen.
Outside kitchen. Isaiah is our finance manager here. Isaiah, how hard or easy is it to get financed on something like this?
Here at the Great Outdoors RV Company, we work with a lot of different lenders, both local and national banks and credit unions. We have helped customers who have not been able to get finance at other dealerships, and we've been able to get them done here because of the great relationships we have with our lenders and because we have so many options. And we like to make that process as easy and as streamlined as possible. Come on down, we will be able to help you out.
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah, we're set up with banks like U.S. Bank, Bank of America, Bank of the West, Blue Credit Union, Arapahoe Credit Union, Weld Schools Credit Union, and a slew of other ones.
The list goes on.
Yeah. So let's talk about some of the cool factors on this thing. What do you think, Isaiah?
Well, right here, you're holding one of the cool factors. This is the large grab handle. This makes it easier to come in and out. It stows nice to the side of the camper when you're driving down the road. But this is a great addition.
Yep, I like that Wildwood on this particular one has power everything. Power awning, power stab jacks, power slide out, power tongue jack, and almost all of that stuff is controlled with just a touch of a remote control or a physical button on the side of the coach.
One power it does not have is a TV.
Yes.
But we can install one for you.
That's
if
right.
You'd like. Absolutely.
Come on over here. We'll show you this outside kitchen. One cool factor is this is not wood. It's made out of like a metal material. So if you do happen to get it wet, you know, if it's raining outside, because it is an outside kitchen, you're not going to ruin the wood.
That is nice and durable, especially for cleanup as well. If you're using it outside with the kids and you're making some meals, or even if you're preparing fish or anything after you're catching it at the lake, this makes it nice and easy to clean up as well. And here's the grill for the outside kitchen where you can grill up that fish that you just caught there at the lake outside of the camper. So that means that you don't have to have the camper full of fish smell and cooking smell or any of those things. You can have everything outdoors, nice and easy, easy to clean up as well.
Now, Isaiah, now that you being from Maui, what kind of fish would you be grilling on this if we were?
Well, in Maui, we like to catch little reef fish called, in Hawaii, we call it the manini, and that's the surgeon fish, the little surgeon fishes, fish there on the reefs of Maui. But here I like to fish for some trout up in the lakes, if there's some nice lake rainbow trout, or even some brookies as well.
Cool.
Also on the outside kitchen, we have here is an electric refrigerator. This runs when you are plugged into your generator or at the campsite where you have some hookups there. So this is a nice little refrigerator for storing a lot of various things, including beverages for the adults, and of course some little juice for the kids.
Now this will only run off of 110 power, so if you're not plugged in, this fridge doesn't work, unlike the fridge on the inside where it's both gas and electric. So that one you'd put spoilable stuff in that one, put like you said cold drinks and stuff like that in this one.
There's also a little bit of storage here.
Nice.
To keep a lot of your outside things, if it's cooking utensils, any plates
that,
a lot of great storage here.
That'd hold a lot of good stuff, all your spices and stuff for your grill.
Mm-hmm.
Awesome. As we continue back here, you have both cable and satellite inputs here. So if you wanted to bring your satellite dish that we sell in our parts store, you can set it right here, plug in there, and then you have cable. Well, I guess you'd bring your receiver from home with your subscription, plug it in there, and then you have satellite.
Yeah, some campgrounds do have some cable hookups if you're staying in any of the long-term campgrounds. I also do want to point out here, it does come with a spare tire with a nice cover to protect the camper. tire, spare tire.
Underneath here, this is a just a normal hookup. This is where your gray and black tank place is. So you'd hook up your sewer hose right here, take the cap off. You'd pull this valve to take out your black tank sewage, and then your gray tank, which is like your shower and sink water, you pull that valve to clean out your hose. I always recommend, before you go camping, throw about 3 or 4 or 5 gallons into your black tank so that you have something to work with, so sludge and whatever else doesn't get built up on the side. You also have a monitor panel inside this coach to tell you when you're full and stuff as well.
While we're down here, I also want to point out the power stabilizer jacks. You can see it, one on this side. Of course, we have one on every single corner. There is the override there. If something happened with the motor, you can override it there as well.
Good feature.
Back here, too, I want to point out this. Here you have your city water connection. If you are at the campground and you have the water available, you can hook it up to here with your water pressure reducer valve that comes with the starter kit that we have available for our customers.
This 30 amp cord is plugged into the side here, so you just pull it out, and that will, you can plug this into like a generator, into campsite power, and that will let you be able to run your air conditioner, your hot water heater, well, not your hot water heater, that'll be off the battery, microwave, mm-hmm. Your 110 outlets.
Yep.
And we also include in the starter kit, like you mentioned, a little reducer valve so it can go from 30 amp down to 110, so you can plug into like a normal outlet like at home if you just need to charge your battery, run the lights, simple things like that.
Absolutely. Come on this way here. We see it does include a very large slide here, which provides a lot of space, livable space in the living room area, which we'll show you when we go inside.
Now this guy weighs, let's see here, 76, about 6,000 pounds dry, 7,700 pounds loaded. So this is towable by most of your half-ton trucks out there. You'll still probably be going a little bit slow up some of the steep hills here in Colorado, but it most likely would get the job done.
Absolutely. Here we have our storage. It is a pass-through storage up front, so you can see there's a lot of space to fit grills, equipment, your lawn chairs, even some firewood for folks. I don't think it'll fit mate though, but there's a lot of room up front.
Proved that in our last video, if you've seen that one. Two 20 pound tanks, power tongue jack. So I like this, has a little nightlight, which I've used once or twice to be able to hook up and unhook when I'm, you know, because a lot of times I'm pulling out right after work, getting to my campsite maybe a little bit later than I thought I was going to get to, and it's nice to be able to see what you're going to be doing when you're messing with all this kind of stuff.
The power tongue jack is a great feature. Like Mate mentioned, you just press the button, it goes up and down, and when you get to the campsite late at night, which most of us do, end up getting there a little bit later, you can flip on the light to see what you're doing to hook up and unhook. I also wanted to point out the great feature here for the cover for your LP tanks. There is a quick release and quick latch so that you can access the valves if you do need to flip one on or off. You can quickly access the 20 pound tanks that does come with it. Part of that starter kit will include filled propane tanks as well.
Yeah, so our dealer handling fee here is $249, and that includes filled propane tanks, a 12 volt deep cycle marine grade battery, sewer hose, water pressure reducer valve, electrical adapter, 60 day temp tag, a full walkthrough. So we like to spend about anywhere from an hour to 2 hours with you, just showing you all the ins and outs of how to use all this stuff, just so that you're up to speed and having the most fun possible on your first camping trip out.
There's also about a 200 to 300 point pre-delivery inspection that occurs as well. It takes a good 3 to 6 hours for our technicians to go through the camper for you to check out all the appliances, pressure test the lines, the plumbing, the electrical, and get all that set before you even come to hook up and leave with the camper. The other thing that our starter kit will come with, of course, is a 60-day temp tag for residents of Colorado. For out of state, it is a 14-day temp tag.
Let's go check out some of the features on the inside.
All right, now we're in the inside.
Inside the Wildwood 273QBXL quad bunk, extra large. Does this actually have four bunks in the back?
It has
one, two, three,
four. Three bunks
and a couch.
The couch
folds into a bed. So
in a whole separate bedroom with a pocket door.
And this couch folds into a bed if you need it to. Has a little bit of storage behind there. These are just armrests or throw pillows, as Tom would like to say.
Yeah, or you can beat each other with it.
You're right. I'm sure your little guys would love these as like extra Nerf swords or something.
I think there was a game show with that once.
Yeah.
So the couch is a great sleeping option, as well as, of course, entertaining. In the event of inclement weather, you can all come in with that slid out. It really does open this area up for a lot of folks to be in this area without stepping on top of each other. And the couch is a place, of course, where folks to congregate, as well as here with the U-shape dinette.
Yeah, people love this. One, because you can actually fit two adults on here if you needed to sleep two more adults.
As a sleeping option,
because you're super long here. I don't know how long.
Well, looks a good six, maybe just over 6 feet. Looks like about 6'3".
If we fold this into a bed real quick, see what happens. One, two. Oh, yeah.
So it's a good 6'3". About 6 feet three.
So I can have my feet there, and I still have plenty of headroom here.
A couple of inches there.
So, yeah, plenty of room. Let's see here. Also, you'll notice these guys are using the wood blinds, and so a little bit more residential feel for this coach. This has glass cooktop in the kitchen, so makes it for more counter space to work with, as well as a nice backsplash. This one does come with an oven. A lot of guys are leaving out the oven on something like this. Microwave, two-way refrigerator with the ice maker, or not ice maker, the
freezer,
thank you. Mm-hmm. And runs off both propane and 110 power, and it's smart where it automatically knows if you're set to 110 power, or it'll switch over to gas if you unplug it. The way that you set this for the temperature, there's just like a little thing that you can slide up and down. So this guy right here, I'll show you, this is your temperature gauge right here. So if you ever wondered how to set the temperature in this guy, it fits right onto this grate here, and you slide it up or down to make it colder or warmer.
We also have the three-burner stove.
Three-burner stove.
Microwave, as well as the exhaust for the stove if you are cooking indoors and a lot of smoke or anything that might be burning. You can flip on the light and flip on the fan to suck that air out and ventilate it.
This is ducted air conditioning throughout, so with the quick cool feature, so you can dump all the cold air right into the living room if you want to, or you can close that and it'll push it out towards the bedrooms.
Wow, that feels great. what a nice feature.
If it was actually working right
if
now.
It was.
Unfortunately, we're out in the middle of the lot.
In the middle of July.
Yes, in the middle of July. You're not. Do you need like an extra coat or something like that?
Yeah, I'm a little chilly.
Let's check
with this quick cold feature.
Yes, yes. In here in the bathroom, you'll notice that we have a tub, which kids, this will come in super handy if you have little guys, which most likely you probably do if you have a coach like this. Skylight, so if you're a little bit taller, you have some extra natural light, as well as headroom in here. You have a medicine cabinet in here. You also have more storage underneath here, and then like a little spot to put like towels and whatever else there on the side.
I like the feature of how they design the bathroom, where you can, a larger person like myself, which is about 6 feet, can sit down here and not have to worry about my knees being right up against a wall or a door.
Yeah.
Very nice and roomy.
Before we head into the bunk room, you'll notice there's a huge pantry area here.
Pantry or closet, storage.
Either one. And this, instead of just a
curtain,
you have a pocket sliding door here. So kids have their own separate bedroom area, which is kind of nice.
Yeah, and just like I mentioned earlier, in the event of inclement weather, there is a lot of space in here for the kids to have their space, their adults to have space up front.
There's even another second TV hookup out here, so that you can put like a TV or a game console or whatever. Put your laptop here for watch DVDs.
Yeah, the 110 power that's available back here also charges your devices as well. back here, which is a nice feature.
Yeah, and there's even a little light right here where you can be reading your book or hanging out. And then, like you had mentioned earlier, this guy does turn into a bed as well, so I could turn this
and flat. The couch lays flat.
Yeah.
With a little bit of storage underneath, too.
Window here, window up top, and then these are emergency windows. So if you need to get out of here in a hurry, you just pull this guy out, and then you can jump out. And it gives a nice cross breeze if you needed some air to move through here. Even just opening this makes a big difference, it feels like. All right.
Well, we'll come back up front to the front area. Here is a spot for a TV. It has a TV backer plate that you can put right on here and mount it and have a spot for your hookups here. It does come with a full sound system and surround sound.
Yeah, and the cool thing about this is it not only has the outside speakers and inside speakers, but this has the DVD player built into it, auxiliary port, USB, a microphone, an SD card slot, so you can take all your pictures during your camping and throw it in there and you can play it on your TV. It also has the Bluetooth feature on here too, where you just push a button, hook it up to your smartphone. Again, pocket doors instead of curtains. And then you can also, through this little hole here, send your cables through here that you have all your cable hookups, and then put your TV on the back side too.
There is some storage up front here for some additional entertainment items or anything else that you might need.
You know, the other thing I really like about this one, Isaiah, is if you're camping, we always have a pile of shoes right in front of the door. And this has a spot for you to put them all so that they're not blocking your walkway the entire camping trip as well. Back here in the bedroom. Again, you have emergency exits on both sides here, as well as this guy lifts up, I believe, sure enough, and has a huge amount of storage. So this
is access the pass-through storage underneath that we saw and looked at outside. You can access that from the inside, any of the items that you have stored in the front.
You'll notice this is plywood decking as well. They use plywood not only underneath their beds, but also on the floors themselves. So this is 5/8 inch tongue and groove plywood decking, so you don't have to worry about getting stuff wet and ruining.
And cupping. Falling apart, flaking.
Yep. Walk around bed so that you can make the bed very easily, as well as storage on both sides, and then a little bit of storage on top as well.
Yeah, I like the walk around feature because you don't have to crawl on top of each other to get to and from the bed area.
And there's outlets on this side and that side, so if you need them, you got them. All right, so that's it for the 273QBXL. Thanks for taking a trip with us on this mini tour.
We'd love to invite you here to the Great Outdoors RV Company, where we can help you with all your camping needs and help you find your weekend.
All right, thanks guys.